If you have an old computer that cannot install newer operating systems, before you completely write it off, you can try to extend its lifespan by installing Linux Lite. This operating system is optimized for older or less powerful computers, making it an excellent choice for revitalizing old devices. Linux Lite boots quickly and applications load rapidly, enhancing the overall user experience. This popular Linux distribution is specifically designed for users transitioning from Windows or those new to the Linux world. The minimum requirements for these operating systems are 1.5 GHz dual core processor, 4 GB of RAM, and 40 GB of free space on a hard drive. To install this operating system, first, visit the official website, the link will be in the video description. Click on the Download Linux Lite button. When the new page loads, you will have the option to choose which version of the operating system you want to download, specifically the three latest stable versions. You can also download the ISO file directly from the website by clicking on the ISO button or in the torrent form by clicking on the torrent button. I will download the installation file directly from the website by clicking on the ISO button, after which I will be able to choose a server from which I want to download the file. This is only important if you have a slow internet connection. In that case, select the server that is geographically closest to you. If you have fast internet, the choice of server is not of great significance. When I click on the desired server, a new page will open with a list of all versions of this operating system released so far. At the top of the list, as you can see, is the first version, 1.0.0. At the bottom of the list is the latest version, which at the time of recording this video is the version 7.6. Since this is a beta version, meaning it is still in testing phase, I will choose latest stable version, 7.4. But you can, of course, select any version you wish. When you click on the version you want, you will receive a new list. To download the installation file directly from the website, click on the first link that ends with the .iso extension. After that, the file download will begin. Once this process is complete, we will create a bootable USB drive. If you are using a Windows operating system, you can use Rufus to create the boot disk. In this case, I will use USBImager, which is one of the newer programs for this purpose. As you can see, it is available for all three major operating systems, Windows, macOS, and Linux. The program is free and open source. The download link will be in the video description. And at the same link, you can also find the source code of the application, as it is an open source project. Since the program comes in a zip format, right click on it, then go to the Extract All option and save the contents in your desired folder. When you run the program, as you can see, it is a simple application. In the first segment, click on the three dots and select the Linux Lite ISO file that we previously downloaded. Then click on the drop-down menu in the middle and select the USB drive where the operating system will be written. After that, click on the right button, which will start the creation of the bootable USB drive. Once the process is successfully completed, restart your computer and select the newly created USB in the boot menu. At the beginning of the installation process, you will have the option to choose what exactly you want to do. If you want to install Linux Lite directly, select the second option, Direct Install Linux Lite. If you want to try this operating system first, select the first option, Boot Linux Lite. If you are installing a specific Linux distribution for the first time, it is always advisable to first run the operating system using the Live System option. As you can see, when the live USB disk boots, you can see how the operating system looks, run programs, install applications, and so on. Everything you do in the live USB disk will not have a permanent effect. Everything will revert to its original state when you restart the computer. If, after testing, you want to install this operating system, in the Welcome segment, click on the Install Now button. At the beginning, you will have the option to choose the language you want. I will leave English selected, but you can, of course, choose any language you prefer. Then we get the option to select the keyboard layout you want to use. After making your choice and clicking the Continue button, you will have the option to configure settings related to the updates and the installation of third-party software. If you want updates to be downloaded during the installation, keep the first option checked, Download updates while installing Linux. The second option, which is not checked by default, Install third-party software for graphics and Wi-Fi hardware and additional media format, allows the installation of property drivers and other software created and signed by manufacturers, which often includes non-open source programs. I will leave this option unchecked. If you do the same and later change your mind, you can always enable it after installation of the operating system. When you click on the Continue button, you will be presented with the options regarding the hard drive where the operating system will be installed. The first option, Erase Disk and Install Linux, if you leave it selected, will completely wipe the content of the hard drive and install Linux. If you want to encrypt the disk, click on Advanced Features button, choose one of the two options provided, and then check the option Encrypt the new Linux installation for security. Click OK to confirm. If you now click on the Install Now button, you will be prompted to set a password that will be used for disk encryption. Additionally, as you can see, there is an option to define a recovery key. If you enable this option, a recovery key will be automatically generated, but you can also define it yourself if you wish. In this segment, you can also check the option Overwrite Empty Disk Space. This option will not increase the free space on the disk, but will perform additional wiping to prevent the recovery of previously stored data. After you have made these settings, click the Install Now button to continue with the installation. If you change your mind and decide not to encrypt the disk, simply go back one step and click on the Advanced Features option again. Then select the first option, None. After that, click on the Install Now button to proceed with the operating system installation. You will receive a summary of the settings you have made. If everything is as you want it to be, click on Continue. Next, you will have the option to set your location. After that, you will need to define a name, username, based on which the computer name will be automatically generated. You will also need to define a password. It is recommended to use strong passwords that include a mix of uppercase and lowercase letters, numbers, and special characters. When you click on the Continue button again, the installation will begin. The installation process should not take long. In my case, it took about 30 minutes. Once the process is successfully completed, you will need to restart your computer by clicking on the Restart Now button. When the computer reboots, the Lite welcome window will open. And in the Start Here segment, there are some basic settings you can configure at the beginning. When you click on this segment, the first recommended step is to update the system itself. To do this, click on the Install Updates button, after which you will need to enter the password you define during the installation process. You will receive a list of everything that will be updated in this process. Click on Update Now button to confirm. Once the system update is complete, the next option is Install Drivers. When you click on this option, if any drivers are missing, you will have the opportunity to install them, and you will usually be offered to choose between the official version of the driver and the open source version. The Set a Restore Point option allows you to configure settings related to the system snapshots. Enter your password, then select the type of the snapshot. After that, you will be given the option to select the disk for which you want to create a snapshot. Then specify the time interval after which a snapshot will be automatically created and how many copies will be kept. When you click on the Next button, you will have the opportunity to define which files will be included in the snapshot. After you configure the settings according to your needs, click on the Next or Finish button. If you want to create the first system snapshot, click on the Create button and wait for the process to complete. If in the Welcome segment you click on the Install Language Support button, you will have the option to configure language settings. You will then have the option to choose whether you want a light or dark theme by clicking on the Light Theme or Dark Theme button. Since we selected the latest stable version of Linux Lite when downloading the ISO file, we have the opportunity to upgrade to the newest version. In this specific case, if you click on the Upgrade button, version 7.6 will be installed, which, as I mentioned earlier, is still in the testing phase. At the end of this segment, you have the option to install applications using Lite Software. When you click on the button with the same name, you will first need to enter your password, after which a new window will open, where you can choose to install new programs by selecting Install Software or remove those that are already installed, in other words, those that come with the operating system, by selecting the Remove Software. When you click on the first option, you will receive a list of all applications that you can install using this program. As you can see, the list of applications available for installation in this manner is not extensive. However, Linux Lite comes with the Synaptic Package Manager pre-installed, which you can use to install applications. Click on Start, then type the name or initial letters of the name of this program. Of course, you will need to enter your password, as the program requires permission to install other applications. If you know the exact name of the application you want to install, click on Search, then type the name of the desired application. You will receive a list of all applications that mention the given name, select the one you want to install, and then click on the Apply button. Since many Linux users want the ability to install Flatpak applications, we will now install the program that will provide us with that capability. You can find the program by simply typing Flatpak into your web browser and clicking on the first link. The link will also be in the video description. When you visit the site, click on the Get Setup button, after which you will have the option to choose the distribution you are using. Since Linux Lite is based on Ubuntu, we will click on the first icon, which represents the Linux Ubuntu logo. You will receive installation instructions. All you need to do is open a terminal and enter the provided commands in the order they are listed. Once the installation process is complete, you will need to restart your computer to start using the program. When the operating system reboots, click on the Start and type Software. Then click on the icon to launch the application. Using this program, you can install almost any applications available on Linux and choose how the application will be installed. For example, I will install Zen Web Browser, which is based on Firefox. The advantage of this browser is that it offers many customization options for its appearance and comes with settings that are further enhanced to provide greater security and privacy. When it comes to customizing the system to meet user needs, there is an application called Lite Tweaks that comes with this operating system. When the program is launched, you will see that all possible settings are divided into two categories: Safe, safe to perform, no harm can be done, and Caution, proceed with caution, involves altering the system files. In the table, as you can see in the grayed column, you can see whether a particular setting is marked as safe or one that requires cautious handling. For example, the option that perform memory cleaning, deleting logs and similar tasks is marked as safe. The option to install the Linux kernel, which you can also perform here, is marked as an action that requires caution. If you want to install the Linux kernel, check that option and then click on the Begin button, enter your password. You will receive a list of all options available for installing the Linux kernel. After we have configured the operating system and installed the applications, we will launch the system monitor. This application comes with the operating system. Here we can see a graphical representation of resource usage, demonstrating that this distribution lives up to its name. Even though in my case Linux Lite is running in VirtualBox, which means that resources are significantly limited, the CPU usage, as you can see, is only around 1-2%. On the graph, it is almost invisible. If we click on RAM, we can see that only about 860 MB of RAM is being used. Using this application, you can view and control the processes running in the background, check which applications start with the operating system, and disable those you do not need, as well as make other system adjustments. Feel free to leave any questions, suggestions, or ideas for future video content in the comments. Thanks to everyone who took the time to watch this video. I hope you find it useful or at least informative.